Welcome back. Hopefully you just watched the video where we found the derivative of the given function without using the quotient rule. Since our denominator is a single term, we were able to divide each term in the numerator by x to the 1/2, simplify, and then apply the basic power rule instead of the quotient rule. But in this video, I want to show how if we do apply the quotient rule, while it is going to be more work, we will obtain the same derivative function. So for reference, here's the quotient rule. Where the derivative of f divided by g with respect to x is equal to g times f prime minus f times g prime divided by g squared. So for our function, f is equal to x squared plus 4x minus 3, and g is equal to the square root of x. But we're actually going to write the square root of x using rational exponents. Remember, square root x is equal to x to the 1/2, because the exponent on x is 1 and the index is 2. So our derivative function will have a denominator of square root x squared, or x to the 1/2 squared. And then for the numerator, we'll have the denominator, x to the 1/2, times the derivative of the numerator, minus the numerator, times the derivative of the denominator. So again, we have g times f prime minus f times g prime divided by g squared. Notice how we haven't found any derivatives yet. We just wrote out the quotient rule. So now we'll go back and find the derivative here, here, and then begin to simplify. Notice in the denominator we have x to the 1/2 squared, so we'd multiply the exponents. 1/2 times 2 is 1. So we have x to the first, or just x in the denominator. And then we have x to the 1/2 times the derivative of x squared plus 4x minus 3. The derivative of x squared is 2x. The derivative of 4x is 4. The derivative of 3 is 0. So the derivative is 2x plus 4 minus the quantity x squared plus 4x minus 3 times the derivative of x to the 1/2. So applying the power rule, we'll have 1/2 times x to the power of 1/2 minus 1 is negative 1/2. So now we'll distribute here as well as here. 1, 2, 3. So f prime of x currently has a denominator of x. Here we'd have x to the 1/2 times 2x to the first power. So we're going to add the exponents. We'll have 2x to the 3/2 plus 4x to the 1/2 minus 1/2 x to the power of negative 1/2 plus 2, that's positive 3/2. 4 times 1/2 is 2, so plus 2 x to the power of negative 1/2 plus 1, that's x to the 1/2. And then finally we have negative 3/2 x to the negative 1/2. Now we're going to clear the parentheses and combine like terms. To clear the parentheses, we can think of distributing a positive 1 here, but because of the minus here, we would distribute negative 1 to clear the second set of parentheses. Let's go ahead and do that on the next slide. Okay, so multiplying by 1 is not going to change anything. So we have 2x to the 3/2 plus 4x to the 1/2. Multiplying by negative 1 here is going to change the sign of each term. So we'll have minus 1/2 x to the 3/2 minus 2x to the 1/2, and then plus 3/2 x to the negative 1/2. Now we'll go ahead and combine like terms, meaning the variable will be the same as well as the exponent. So these two terms are like terms, and these two terms are like terms. So we have f prime of x equals 2x to the 3/2 minus 1/2 x to the 3/2. 2 minus 1/2 is 3/2, so we have 3/2 x to the 3/2. And then 4x to the 1/2 minus 2x to the 1/2 is plus 2x to the 1/2. And then finally, we still have plus 3/2 x to the negative 1/2. All this is still divided by x. But now again, because we're dividing by a single term or a monomial, we can divide each term in the numerator by x to simplify this. So we'd have f prime of x equals 3/2 x to the 3/2 divided by x, which is actually x to the first, plus 2x to the 1/2 divided by x to the first, plus 3/2 x to the negative 1/2 divided by x to the first. Remember, when dividing, we subtract the exponents if the bases are the same. So finally, we have f prime of x equals 3/2 x to the power of 3/2 minus 1 is 1/2, plus 2 times x to the power of 1/2 minus 1 is negative 1/2. And here we have plus 3/2 x to the power of negative 1/2 minus 1 is negative 3/2. Let's continue on the next slide. Just as before, we can leave this in a variety of forms. Let's at least write this so that we have positive exponents. Meaning if we move these two to the denominator, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So we'd have f prime of x equals 3/2 x to the 1/2 plus 2 divided by x to the 1/2 plus 3 divided by 2 x to the power of 3/2. So this would be our derivative function. And if we compare this derivative to the other video where we didn't use the quotient rule because we simplified first, notice how it took a lot less work, but the derivative function here is still the same. Now for the last part, we're asked to find f prime of 4, which means we'll just substitute 4 for x into our derivative function. And again, to save time, I've already done this. This simplifies to 67/16, which is equal to 4.1875, which would be the slope of the tangent line of our function at x equals 4. Let's go ahead and look at that. Here's our function. Here's the point on the function when x equals positive 4. So if we sketch a tangent line at that point, it might look something like this. And since f prime of 4 was equal to 67/16, this would be the slope of this blue tangent line. I hope you found the comparison of the two techniques to find the derivative function helpful.